say entrepreneurship is a journey, not a sprint. So in 2008, Making Moves has showcased over 150 young entrepreneurs across all 9 provinces. Bonke labo somabhizinisi business, basebenza kuma sectors adlulela ku 15 kwesimo somnotho sakuleli. Kule season we revisit some of these businesses to find out what moves that they've been making since our last visit. It doesn't matter how slow you go, as long as you keep on moving. Making Moves, inspiring a generation of young entrepreneurs. In today's episode, we relook at 3 entrepreneurs who are changing the face of men's fashion in Mzansi. We first met Sbusiso Ngwenya of Skinny Sbu Socks in season 6 as a young entrepreneur who was trying to break into men's fashion. Since then, he has managed to grow his clientele and now he supplies his socks to one of the country's major fashion outlets.
If I was a musician, I'd have reached a gold status. We're able to sell 20,000 units in 1 month.
I know, nice.
You know.
Later, we meet Sphamandla and Sandile of SIMONI Exclusive, two entrepreneurs who are passionate about high-end men's exclusive wear. Since we last saw them, they have managed to secure an office for operation structure, increase their revenue and staff members.
If you look at this shop, it's now wider, it's more open. So the same look you see here, you're gonna see when we go to other stores, the same look.
In 2013, the clothing, textiles, footwear, and leather industry accounted about 14% of manufacturing employment and represented South Africa's second largest source of tax revenue.
Fashion, as you know, evolves all the time, but the evolution is very much a circular kind of a thing. It happens in a circle.
The trends with men's fashion, it varies with different cultures.
I think the fashion industry in South Africa is finding itself.
In 2005, the South African market for clothing and textile products combined was 45.6 million rand.
I'm not really into fashion, don't know much about fashion, but it has changed a lot and it's trending, it's in a good way.
Where we mostly spend our money on is on like our local stores, but then most of the times when you look at your labels, it's made in China and everything.
South Africa was the 86th largest exporter of clothing, exporting around 878 million rand. And the 37th largest importer in this sector, importing 11.9 billion rand.
The first thing would be that local designers' clothes are more expensive because they're quality clothes.
So I think men spend more money and they're more into brands. I'm just into looking good. So if I can get the look for less, then that's what I'll do.
South Africa's exports of clothing grew by 31% from 2012 to 2013, reaching 908.7 million rand.
There were a lot of young, exciting designers who brought different elements to men's fashion.
The industry facilitates an estimated 60 to 80,000 jobs and contributes around 8% to the country's GDP.
What has been interesting so far is the development of new trends in terms of color schemes and men wearing colors that, you know, they would never have thought of wearing before.
Guys, street just so wet on this was hanging and in this while then I get as a colleague of Kulama social network pages where to won't get a lana emzans. Last time we know we won a lens is over 2014. Lapoconagi and the Masoris Wayo Akamila as one of two skinny Sbu Socks. Since then, things have changed the business in like. Business like a little Jovel and Gangela, eh, is manga cool. Lapoga foot sector against the Thai Samasorisake, where Zinia Gazette or as it to make a cool lapaga emzans. Zotana Nagelana get box shop, Gizo Woody a business like it. Yinigas it doesn't zero Woody, the Kukua foot, little to really a family.
Sanibani Mzansi, Kamalamu Sbusiso Ngwenya. I'm a 24-year-old entrepreneur. Ngibuye le e-Israel, ndetsakane. That's where I come from. Abaningi bangazi ngomasokisi, bangazi ngosibu masokisi. I'm the founder and managing director of Africa's leading luxury brand, Skinny Sbu Socks. I'm crazy about Johannesburg culture. I'm a creative at heart. I'm a storyteller and I'm an aspiring actor. And I love socks.
Yes, as well.
It's been a while.
2.5 years.
Kunjani
makoko? Hawu koko right as a mfethu. Angiyazi feeling yena ukuthi ufila kanjani, but ngiyacanga ukuthi uma umuntu invest your all on someone, yes, especially, and then you see them actually going the direction of now buy a boy.
Yeah.
It's a very fulfilling thing, you know. Yes, kodwa yena ujabulile nje, siyalwa, siyaxabana. I usually go visit her late and stuff, yabona. But I make time for her, but she's happy.
She's happy.
Sanibani, namhlanje sisetsakane eGaslami, Semasinga Street. Uyabona ama holiday abantwana base Stratton kuyadlalwa kumnandi. Kula ngikhulele khona lana, ngihlala nogogo wami, uSisimimi.
Sbusiso kwa no quiet even now, isale ngwa no quiet. Azange kathola problem ka Sbusiso.
Usamnayekele,
awungeke ngihlale ngamnayekeli.
Yabona
ugogo wami, hey, she means the world to me.
Yes, sir.
Above everything else, above financial support and everything, you need someone who's just going to be there for you. Yabon. So, ugogo wamuyenze lento leyo for the past 24 years. Yeah. And manje mina njengoba sengiqala ukupopa nami, why not return the favor?
Sing some punch esontweni sonke. And elinye ithema lathi kithi, you know these boys, if bacala manje ukubhayisa ama punch, 5 years time bazoba kuphi? And today, Sbu is pushing his own thing, ubhayisa ama socks, and the business is doing well.
It's a size 20, but I made a decision a long time ago not to go to church.
Yeah.
Nothing personal and stuff.
Into engijabulisayo ukuba nabangani bami esikhathini esiningi, you know, ngikhona lapho ukuthi ngingacabangi ngebusiness or ngezinye izinto. Abantu engikhule nabo, so we just have fun all the time masonke. Sithole i-reason yokuhleka all the time.
Amajita kuphi mfethu? Because last time sixoxa nawe ngithi why you paintballing namajita, ngibona nizikhipha lapha kumnandi. Usawabona amajita?
Amajita wami, we've been together for a decade now.
Yeah.
Tepo has Tepo Jeans, which is doing very well. Ngigqokile namanje.
Yes, sir.
And then Julius has his marketing agency. He's been in school for the past 4 years as a postgrad for marketing.
Ngicela ukuseta
mfethu, ngithe nje abakufakele utho lapho very much. Yabona?
Yeah, thanks. So manje uSbu mangabe angekho eSpanini, maka relaxile, uthanda ukwenzani insizwa mangabe uyithatha ufuna ukuphola nje uchill?
Well, mina ayi, mina mfethu ukutshela iqiniso, yabona nginilethe la ngenhloso vele. Yabona, I'm a huge fan ye coffee.
Noma kushisa?
Ngisho noma kushisa, mfela ngikhulisa ugogo mina mfethu.
Ayi, konje abogogo bazokufaka itiye ne-coffee one way.
Ngiyazithandela i-coffee plus.
Yeah. No, ngiyakuzwa insizwa yakithi. Uma ngabe uSbu kuthiwa kumnyama, hey, kulikhuni insizwa, izinto nje azihambi kahle. What keeps you going?
A while back, bengibukele i-interview ka Warren Buffett,
yes, sir,
the world's most richest man, 2008.
Yes.
Bambuza naye ukuthi do you think entrepreneurship is for everybody? And wabuya wathi lalela, for you to go into business, you necessarily don't need to be the most educated person. Or we have a good background, a line in a mile corner, or whatever. You need to be a spiritually sound person. And get kabang gutinamu when there's dark clouds around me, gibuye lagule yonto leonjalo to say, you know what, I have a much deeper connection with Nkulunkulu wam. We've developed our own relationship. And I go back to him like any child would go to his father and really ask for guidance. And sometimes you just want someone to talk to. Amachita siyakwazi ukubamba izinto, yabona. But mina ngibona ugogo nje manje khona into emhluphayo uzokutshela, hey siya, ezingihlushwa yini, azitshele nobani, that's therapeutic, you know. So I've learned to open up really to abantu who are around me. You know, ugogo wami, umama wami, uAntwam, sisi wami. and nginabangani futhi around me who are really supportive, you know. Plus my girlfriend on top of that, you know, it's very supportive and open-minded person.
I says really sister siyambonga man ukuthi khona.
Your motto, yeah.
Yeah. What is your motto in life, Kuti?
My motto in life is bite more than you can chew and chew like crazy. If you have the energy, start 10 projects and work 10 times more.
Yeah, well,
you know, so that's my theory all the time.
Yeah.
I'm the founder and managing director of Africa's leading luxury brand, Skinny Sbu Socks, which is locally designed and locally manufactured. We are proud of the Skinny Sbu Socks brand, and today, Silai Soweto Vilakazi Street, we chose this particular venue purely because it ties in with what the Skinny Sbu Socks brand stands for. Iconic people and talented people lived on the street, and that is what Skinny Sbu Socks stands for. As in Indawo Footwear, you can get Skinny Sbu Socks at Starter Forts, you can get Skinny Sbu Socks at SIMONI exclusive. Also, you can find Skinny Sbu Socks on Spree and at skinnysbusocks.co.za.
So it's up there, it doesn't work last year.
Yes, sir.
What we are doing here is a designer, I'm a Skinny Sbu Socks, right?
Yeah.
Skinny Sbu Socks, we were sourcing socks and distributing them. Right?
Imagine this is Sandile. We are designing the socks locally.
Yes, sir.
And the swag is a corner local, like
nice.
In Mzansi.
Yeah.
And I've been insistent with Timmy Amuguti. I'm also going to tell you to Mzansi for one reason. When you go to the factory in Cape Town, there's a squatter camp there, and they employ something like 60 people.
Yeah.
So I mean, I go to bed as a happy man knowing that my hustle in Johannesburg goes on to feed something like 60 families back in Cape Town. So we found a model of how to release our collection weight.
Yeah,
so we release something like 5 designs every 3 months.
Okay.
So ngizokuchazela nje kancane bhuti wami. And we wanted to tell an authentic kasi South African story, you know, and unfold ngale ndlela le. This is something that my sister will be turned. Abaning by busy scotch, abaning by busy steel. So we just drew a scotch, this is the ground, and then we drew the entire scotch. You hope scotch, mostly it's played by girls. See, Vilakazi Street here, Nelson Mandela lived in the same street, Desmond Tutu. You know, it's a very iconic street. Mm-hmm. And why not take the map of the entire Soweto, Saifinga nje kancane, and then we put it in a sock. This is my personal favorite, and I know it will resonate with everybody.
Yes.
You know, because we're telling a South African story. Lena Freedom Charter, we took Amakama Jagamil Lapano, people shall share, people shall govern the land. So we're just telling a purely South African story.
Yeah, no, intentionally. Abantu baye bangakuthola kuphi? And futhi na usadayisa futhi na ku social media.
It was very easy dealing with Skinny Sbu, and I mean the process was so quick, and I actually didn't expect delivery so quickly, so I'm quite happy.
Happy customer, happy business, all good.
Sure. Let's talk distribution for a second. You have one store that stocks your product, Maboneng District. I mean, is that enough? And what plan is in place to increase your distribution network?
It's not enough, you know. We are really trying to figure out ways of making sure that our socks get to our customers. And we are in talks with 3 other stores that are Joburg based and would like really to expand that number. methods of distributions have changed.
Yes.
They're cool. Yeah, but, and especially with the introduction of social media, that means that me and Nanguskin Sbu Socks, manje njoba nginawe on Instagram alone, we have something like 12,700 people following us. That's an audience of 7,000 people, 12,000 people that I can sell to. So I need to be able ukuthi ngikwazi ukukhuluma ulimi labo, ngikwazi ukukhuluma nabo ngendlela abayithandayo, ngendlela abazo understand, and that will lead us to selling the product, you know. So, and that will mean that you also look at ways of traditional ways of distribution. So istolo lesi box shop is one of the ways where we are distributing the product in a traditional way. Istolo. We also have Simon exclusive, and I'd like to take you there.
Yeah.
Uibone, now it's a totally different setup compared to last corner namhlanje. But also we're catering for a new age market where people can go online and purchase amasokisi wabo. Ispirit.co.za, which is one of the country's leading fashion online store. And then people can also buy directly from Skinny Sbu Socks. They can go to skinnysbu.co.za and buy products abo lab. But guess here, Tina, we're a brand that really thinks for our people. And we know that Imzansi is not yet ready to buy online. So we cater for people who just want to send an email and pay via EFT or send a deposit. So we have those systems put in place for people to really access
Amasokisi wabo. Yes, sir. But if you want to buy a new one, you can buy a shop. Because you are able to buy a new one, you can buy a new one, you can buy a new one, you okay, so take it.
It was easy for me to open up conversation with everybody purely because I'm a specialist in what I do. We are Africa's leading luxury male brand. So people babega equality umsebenzi wethu. People look at the authentic stories we're telling as a brand. People look at which we are very ethical brand. We produce local and things like that. And lezo zinto lezo, then the conversation ibe much easier nabantu abaona itolo.
Yes, sir. Like I think it's I maybe ngicela ukuthenga leli ibhala leli ngibeka amasokisi ami ngizonibona every month or ni pomula ama cent nyana to according to whatever is
we see. Well, you know what, Epoch Shop, what they did is they went all over South Africa and said how many designers do we have, and abasafufusayo noma abasakhulayo.
Yes.
And then they said we're going to take care of your distribution. So in distribution abantu bacama ukuthi it's saying to people here's the end product. In distribution it's also the manufacturing part. So they come to you and they say wenza amasokisi wayenza kuphi imalini asikuncedisa sikunikeza imali to do that, but also asikunikeza in a space and a market where people can come and really access your product.
Yes.
What's your break even point? How many socks?
How many socks? For me to break even, we will need to sell 900.
So 900 socks a month and you break even. How far are you from that?
Very far.
So now what model or approach would you advise him to take in order to implement some of the advice you've given him today?
Well, I actually want him to speak for himself because I think he got it.
Gokala njenga tanguti ubudumongezi helped me a lot, you know. I came here, I knew my problems, but I ignored them. He made me realize a lot of things about my brand. Mm-hmm. The first thing that he helped me with is to identify 100 people, because I think you heard also, I had a very ambitious number. I want to make 1 million, I want to sell 1 million units and stuff, you know. He said I should start with the simple things. Identify 100 people, their names, where they live, where they wear socks and how they wear socks and stuff. Once I get that info, sell to those people, and then I can start growing and adding to that number. You know, really, he helped me with getting the basics right.
Siya yazi bekunzima nokuthengisa ngisho amasokisi i-100. And we've been able to do that and exit that. Kule nyanga lena esikuyo mina nawe manje. The reason why I dyed my hair gold is because I reached a gold status. So if I was a musician, I'd have reached a gold status. We're able to sell 20,000 units in 1 month.
I know, nice.
You know,
nice.
So,
nice.
Komisa ukukhula lokuthi 2 years, 2.5 years ago, we struggled to even sell 100 units.
Yeah.
And now we're able to sell close to 20,000 units in 1 month.
Yeah.
ucabanga ukuthi iziphi izinto ozenzile ezenza ukuthi brand yakho ikwazi ukuthi indlondlobale kakhulu kuma social media wethu?
Sisese ku developmental stage.
Yes, sir.
So sisese ku stage where we still experimenting yonke into. A part of it kuba a natural instinct. Njengoba ngitshela ukuthi I'm a storyteller. I enjoy and I love storytelling.
Yes, sir.
We still also go to social media aspects. Abazositshela ukuthi most of the time this is what works on social media. So people react to great pictures.
Yeah.
People react to well shot pictures.
Yes.
And a great story that couples that thing, you know. So sisese gule, we're still finding a delicate balance of what it is that works for the brand and what do the experts say. You know.
With Skinny Sbu Socks, we consult. We give them brand advice. Most importantly, even with collaborations with various brands, what are the impacts would it have in terms of his brand equity and what it takes to build the brand equity as well. And not most importantly, not just looking at the short-term goals of whereby certain clients are willing to give the money to co-brand with Skinny Sbu Socks and understanding as well that he's building a premium brand quality sock. The artistic work the Skinny Sbu has been doing, it's unseen before in terms of the ZA Royalty collection as well. He's literally made socks a canvas.
This is SIMONI Exclusive, one of their branches. As you can see, everything ties into the offering. More formal. It's more discerning, and it says, you know what, I know what I want, I'm a go-getter, and this is what I want, you know. And yeah, I really love SIMONI Exclusive, and it ties in beautifully with the Skinny Sbu Socks brand and the type of gentleman is naye. Gulage, where we sell the high-end part of Skinny Sbu Socks. A pair retails for 200 rands. You can see this one, the artist, this one was more Da Vinci inspired. And then we sat down with the artist and really worked on it.
Yabona leli lihlukile kunalawa ngikhombisa bona eliyabona. Lawayana bewakhuluma mo, you know, ngilokishi is identifier kakhulu thina abantu amnyama emalokishini. Lana ke manje hayi leli ngiyalibona leli into le incwasimendeke leli abantu abasikazike leli. Yebo baba.
Everything starts in the mind. If you cannot think positive, if you cannot think of yourself as a winner, you cannot win.
Liz Ditsekho is the CEO of the National Mentorship Movement, an exciting collaboration between the Black Management Forum. She's passionate about entrepreneurship, particularly amongst the youth. She is a franchise owner and has held various positions at leading international companies. Her qualifications include BA Social Science, PDM, and two MBAs. She's currently pursuing her PhD. She will be our advisor for the day.
Manje ke amachallenge obhekene nawo ebhizinisini lakho imaphi ke mntawa?
I think izinga manje is expansion, you know, and distribution. I think we've addressed the distribution in the Gauteng region, you know. We now are known as a global brand. We now want to play in that space, you know. I'd like for people to go to Nigeria, to Abu Dhabi, to almost everywhere in the world and find a pair of Skinny Sbu Socks.
All right, there are three things that I think Sbu can do to expand outside of Gauteng and internationally. Two of those things he's doing already. He just needs to keep on doing them and keep on doing them better. The first is his partnership with the likes of SIMONI. There are other smaller businesses that are into clothing retailing, boutique-like kind of stores that he could partner with outside of Gauteng. And the second thing would be his strategy of involving brand personalities into his business. What he's doing with Trevor Noah and Black Coffee, for example, he needs to find more of those kind of people people who resonate with his brand, so people who live his brand, so people who idolize his brand. He needs to find more of them outside of Gauteng and outside of the country as well. He's already in two of Stratford stores, and there's nothing stopping him from approaching other big retailers. If he goes into Woolies, I know that they buy on a regional basis, for example, so if they list him into Gauteng, it's going to be the whole of Gauteng. If they list him into the Western Cape, it's the whole of the Western Cape.
So I think another thing is for Dylan and Skin Sbu Socks is now venture into now making the product ourselves, you know, because we're still outsourcing that. Yes, it's still made locally by a local factory, but we want to take that as an initiative.
What Sbu needs to do is to run a cost-benefit analysis. He needs to determine what expenses will come with setting up and running his own manufacturing plant, as opposed to outsourcing, which he's doing now. And only once he's done that exercise, he'll be able to know what is more profitable for his business.
I think manufacturing and being global, really, that is where we want to take it. But also I'm influenced by designers like Tom Ford, Tommy Hilfiger, and Ralph Lauren, who moved from just selling a simple piece as socks to now even selling bedding, cups, and clothes, you know? And we'd really like to venture into that.
Well, two pieces of advice, really. I would say that perhaps the first stage in terms of him expanding his product or extending his product will be to stick within the same categories. Generally, clothing for men's socks tends to be done by us women. So I would say that Sbu needs to expand his marketing efforts to reach women as well, as opposed to just marketing to men.
Skinny Sbu Socks is becoming a signature brand in Mzansi. It is great to see that his business is growing in leaps and bounds. Now we head to SIMONI Exclusives, head office in Johannesburg CBD, to meet Sphamandla and Sandile.
So we in the Kulu Manjis Bangela in the Mizu, good luggage. Kulamalanga says one abandoning giga best lisa. 700 Nayela would bona, Bakoa Ranjan. Namkanjala making moves, pertains to his in Billy Gaz, Pumala Payana was Simon. Back then, Namototala Nate, Orodana, Zimbala Bebenas. What do I give to the Isin to Sebes Kukulil, Jongo Baga Futi, Sebapin the Futi about Fulaga Ezina Eton, Lapokona, Betaisa Kona, Impassion, Yaban to best lisa. Ngifuna ukwazi-ke ukuthi bona yini-ke into abayenzile futhi-ke ngifuna ukwazi ukuthi maphi kamasaba nawo azobasiza ukuthi ibhizinisi labo lindlondlobale kuzona-ke lezi ezey'mpahla zabantu besilisa.
I was born in a small town in KZN called Newcastle. That's where I did my high school. And after I was done, I went to go and start at Varsity. I am a co-founder of a company called SIMONI Exclusive. This is something that I'm very passionate about. I believe being an entrepreneur, I'm able to control my life and do whatever it is that I want to do whenever I want to do it.
I'm an entrepreneur and I'm a co-founder of SIMONI Exclusive. I started my schooling career back in Newcastle and moved to Joburg. In Joburg, I realized when I finished my matric that my parents did not have money to take me to school. Today, I'm holding a business management diploma, training certificate, and a business administration certificate, all achieved through personal learning. My life is a living testimony that through God, all things are possible. My son started grade one this year. It's something that's in the pipeline,
it's
Mama.
Something in the pipeline.
Yeah.
How shall I mean?
Eish, my brother. Oh, Wamanje, I'd rather not talk about it, you know. I think, Wamanje, my focus is mainly on the business, you know.
It's been on the business.
Yeah, yeah, it's been on the business. There is someone in my life who's very special.
Yeah.
And I spend whatever time I get now,
yeah.
You know, and I also spend a little bit of time in the family. Yeah.
Outside work, what I do is I spend time with my family most of the time. However, every now and then, I'm not going to cheat.
When I'm out not working, we come hang out like ALM Puchari, Skisinyama.
To be honest. So we're always working. If we're not in South Africa, we're traveling.
Yes.
You know, that adolescent stage, they were very stoked. But, you know, Amachita,
naughtiness, abantwana. I was maybe coming late at school. I was spinning imoto. I was stealing. I was on drugs. So I think in life, in childhood, yeah, I was just a big mess. Woman.
Spa.
Yes, sir.
We know how to do it. But as in individually, Spa. This is who he is today.
Yes.
This is who I am. This is what I stand for today.
Uspa is a very driven individual.
Nakul.
I want to see things happening. You know, I want to change the world in whatever way I can. And I believe with whatever influence that I have right now, I've been able to inspire, I've been able to motivate a lot of young people to even start thinking positive, you know, because everything starts in the mind. If you cannot think positive, if you cannot think of yourself as a winner, you cannot win. If you cannot think of yourself as a fit person or that person that takes care of himself, you cannot do it. I've been engaging with a lot of young people in my personal time, spare time. We've done projects together in SIMONI, like building people and shaping, because more than anything, it's the mind. If you shape the mind, then the body and everything else will follow. You know, yeah.
Yes. It starts in the mind.
Shape the mind.
On another hand, my brother, I believe in a higher power, Joe.
Hallelujah.
So, I'm a strong believer in the word. Yeah, we've got an office, my brother. Hey, growth, we find that you can't manage growth in the boot of the car.
Yeah.
I mean, for the whole of last year, we never opened a single store, but we opened this office at the beginning of the year.
For now, I don't think so. The number of staff that they have now should be sufficient for the stage that they are at for now.
Yes, sir. Systems in place. Systems in place. As a business, we figured out it's made not only of a shop. You've got your operations, you've got your marketing, you've got your finances, you've got your research and development. You need to keep your employees' files in order. You need to keep your books in order. So such things you can't run. In everything a routine.
Yeah.
You need an office one way or the other.
If you look at our stores, Neshopu Air 4 Ways, Neshopu Air Clan Vista, which is in the south, that's north, and then Konese East.
It takes me the same time to go to 4 Ways, Greenstone, and Clan Vista when we're here. So we are more central when we're here.
And also, this is an incubation. So there's a lot of other businesses in the same building. So we are able to collaborate and be able to get services in the same building that we are in.
They actually have bigger dreams of growth. So for them,
it's not a weakness, it's something that they must watch out for, is to how to swing such that you don't fall over yourself. So that's the one thing that I picked up.
What is the most helpful piece of advice or insight that came out of your discussion?
As big as our dreams are and our vision, but we need to be able to break everything down into smaller pieces and then take them step by step.
Ah, bafethu.
Yes.
Office lenu, nice, compact and clean. Yona into engiyithanda.
Yeah, but ngoba sisho nje ukuthi kunosisi osebenza la ekhaya.
Yes.
She's currently on maternity leave. She's working from home. She's a bridge between us and the stores. Mm-hmm. So they report to her, then she reports to us, vice versa. So we come here from time to time, Tina.
So we are again, you know, not in the lack of a better way. Oh, my balan was like, I'll cook a yunk into na yela yunk.
Yes.
Cook a name pillows it. She makes sure we attend ama meetings on time, because we tend to forget, you know, there's just a lot of stuff that we have to keep in our minds.
Yeah, you know, when you're going to be a boat, you're going to sell value, my responsibilities, which you know, and you're going to
mean, I manage operations, finance, and HR. OSPA manages the more technical stuff, your marketing, your IT, and website. He's responsible for bringing in the clients.
Okay.
And when they hear, my systems must see to it that they get served.
Yeah.
No, we try and share, man. It's all about teamwork, you know?
But I don't know about the last time I was in the house, I was in the house, I was pop-up stores, I was in the house.
I met the guys a year ago, and you know, I've been meeting no Sandile basement, and you know, every time when I see the guy, he's looking good, man. Looking good all the time. Tell me, man, where did you get your stuff or what?
Sawenza lo bona, savashela ama client ama pop-up stores in sawenza now.
Kuningi esikwenzayo, but kuningi futhi esisikhathe back kukho, because as the business grows, you check your priorities. We can't be everywhere at all times. So we had to relook at our model. So our model is more of trying to get our clients to the stores as opposed to serving them.
Yes.
Of course, you get those clients where you have to still go to them and serve them as individuals.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm
a pop-up stores, I say, corner,
no, pop-up stores, not really. You know, right now, we're busy packaging our systems way too. We do like something like fashion shows.
Yes,
you
yes.
know, big things now.
Yeah. We're moving, Baba.
Yeah.
Basically, a lot has changed, bruh. One, our logo has changed. You can see we've got a red eye now.
Yeah.
Basically, red is a sign of confidence.
Yes.
If Simone was Simone, but it's more confident that you can take anyone on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So any confident man is welcome at Simone.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
If you remember previously, it was those dark colors and it was more enclosed. So as you grow in business, you learn new things, you see how other people, because this business is about selling clothes as opposed to how the shop looks. So we decided if we open up the clothes, it's easier for people to walk in and exactly see what they want.
We have really improved the offering to Kakulu. It's a bit wider than it was before, you know. And also, we've always had this thing with Simone. It's about being unique, and it's been about being exclusive. We've always believed that men should not look the same, you know. So that is the foundation of Simone, and that will never change. Simone will always be about exclusivity.
I actually met them at a very, very powerful event, National Achievers Congress, recently. I'm always attracted to young, emerging African leaders and their enthusiasm and courage. That made me to be attracted to them, and also to see that they are very, very confident of their company. Well, you know, obviously, to see these young emerging leaders dressed up like that in an event like that, that made me to come closer to them, because, you know, you could tell that they are standing out.
What we're doing with our preparations to franchise the brand, we're keeping a common look. So the same look you see here, you're gonna see when we go to other stores, the same look.
So same nabasebenza bangayenze sana nabo ke ngamanje itolo nazo ziyanda
ziyanda. Currently we've got 9 full-time staff that work for us.
Yes.
Yeah, they're rotating some of them, and then we've got head office staff.
I've been working for Simoni for more than 1.5 years, which makes me permanent now. I'm a day-to-day activities in the store. Like, before I open the show, I make sure that you be like 30 minutes earlier on before you start your shift, which is basically taking care of the floor cleaning and do my daily duties, which is like making sure if the mannequins are also clean, there's no dust around it, everything on point. You know, at first, as when you be introduced to the new guys and it's being a black man owned, you've been thinking a lot of things. Hey, these guys maybe might be difficult. But I never find that with these guys that I'm working with. It's been like I'm working with my brothers at the same time. That's how I feel. I feel like I'm at home.
Usimoni hello.
Usimoni hello.
Usimoni gacho.
Yeah.
So this is one of our latest offering. As you can see now, you know, I'm a suit, a lot of our suits is season. It allows for people to play around with different checks and different colors of checks.
They need to manage customers' expectations. You know, they need to rather under promise and over deliver.
Speaking of our challenges, challenges when you know what routine there was a stage like on airport, check into.
Because I mean, we now manufacturing our own clothes.
Yes.
We've got our own suppliers, which are not other people's brand, but exclusive to Simoni. So that on its own, it's giving us that exclusivity. We don't have a problem. They detain our clothing all the time at the airport. It's procedure. A week or so later, then they release them. That on its own, it's another challenge for a small business like ours, because sometimes you find that you wait for a week or two waiting for clothing that's already in the country. And it challenges a lot in terms of delivering to our customers way too on time.
Yes, sir.
However, yeah, it's part and parcel of the game that we're in.
Well, what I'm hearing here is an issue of logistics and operations management. So they just need to make sure that there is enough stock in the stores. And in terms of, I don't know if they ever go out to pre-promote or pre-market stock that they don't have yet. But if they do that, they need to manage customers' expectations. You know, they need to rather under-promise and over-deliver. So if they're expecting a certain item in 2 weeks, they should rather say to a customer that it will, you know, should arrive in 3 or even 4, just to manage the customer's expectations and you know, to gain the customer's trust and loyalty.
So ama current challenges enibheni nawo madoda ke imaphi ke la khona sazuthi ongqondo ngqondo bethu uma ngabe sibehleli becwaninga yonke into bangansiza nganeke bafuthi.
Yeah. I think one of our challenges right now is expanding, you know. So we're busy preparing to expand. But in expanding, we need to take care of some issues. Like, for instance, we need to have big stock. You know, we need to have ample stock in our stockroom that we can able to supply to all the stores. Mm-hmm. And then that means we need a cash flow of some sort, mm-hmm. you know, because mm-hmm. cash flow, as you know, up until now, no one has really injected anything into this business.
Reinvesting money back into business is always a good thing to do. So I applaud them for that. They're doing good. In terms of getting a partner to come in and inject some, you know, cash flow, I would warn against that for now. Not a bad thing, but maybe not at this stage of the business. What I would advise instead is for them to rather focus on building their brand.
We also have, I mean, a little bit of challenges in terms of human power and the resources, mm-hmm. you know, because, like, you know, we've spoken about the fact that in between the two of us, we do a lot of duties.
Yeah.
So, Tina, we can then be able to promote and market the business and get more business for Isimoni.
For now, I don't think so. I think, as I've just stated earlier on, they need to rather focus on brand building activities. The number of staff that they have now should be sufficient for the stage that they are at for now.
Prophet, you guys are big dreamers.
Yes.
Where to from here for Isimoni?
Isimoni, more than anything, my brother, I can tell you, Guti, we more interested in building the brand Simoni more than expanding stores.
Yo, nice.
We can open stores every day if we want to, but there is no sustainability there. We want to see money go by business that will outlive even our lives. Mm-hmm. Hence, we more focus in terms of building the system. We need to go as far as sitting here in South Africa and connecting with our suppliers overseas online and placing the orders and getting them to come to South Africa.
I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. I think Sandile is on point. If I were to just give one piece of advice for this business, I would say this will be it. Focus on building a brand. It's not about the number of stores that you own. It's not about building a footprint. You're not a bank and you're not an ATM. You know, people can still find you online. People can still find you via various distribution channels. So build a brand, make it known, create awareness, create equity, and create brand resonance. And then everything else will fall into place.